sit back, relax, and I hope you enjoy. Much love to all.
The dog. Other members of the Canis genus or dog include wolves, coyotes, and jackals. The wild dog, namely the jackal, was the first to be separated from the wolf line. Later the fox separated. In recent times, the wolf has increased the number of coyotes in America and the southern areas. Finally, a small breed of the so-called wool belongs to a version of the domestic dog, which in turn gave rise to the dingo in Australia. The dingo is a separate species from the so-called domestic dog. Since dogs belong to the same lineage of animals as wolves and jackals, they are also capable of attacking you. It is in his blood to be as they are, dogs. The dog is carnivorous by nature. So if someone says, "Oh, don't be afraid, it won't hurt you," think about this information. The dog is the oldest known so-called pet. Remains have been found in Denmark dating back to the earlier part of the Middle Ages, known in human culture as the Isilian. Shortly afterwards, dogs appeared in the Mesopotamian Valley, the place where the first dog had been acclimatized to Central Europe. The dingo, typically a wild animal, is sometimes semi-domesticated in Aboriginal camps. Its ancestors were brought as domestic dogs to Australia by the first immigrants several thousand years ago, and were later allowed to roam in the wild. Now ask yourself, how can you really tame a wolf, coyote, or jackal and be sure that he won't attack you sooner or later? You can't be 100% sure. It is difficult to interpret any behavior in a dog as abnormal, because an animal will adapt to a situation in a way that gives it satisfaction. However, as bizarre as this may seem to the observer, unusual behavior can also result in organic diseases. Any obvious change in behavior, such as convulsions, often called spasms, and the like, are usually indications of a serious illness. Dogs that are confined to small spaces for long periods of time will often develop the habit of walking in circles or jumping from side to side when a person approaches them. A dog left alone in a home for long periods of time will often chew furniture or even attack children and adults. This behavior, which comes from the Canis genus, can be interpreted as a frustrated attempt to escape. All dogs, without exception, have at one time or another tried to bite their master, or a family member, or a friend. Another species of Canis is Canis lupus, the gray wolf. The gray wolf was originally found throughout Europe, Asia, and North America, and has a highly variable breed and local varieties. A wolf is an animal that looks a lot like a large German shepherd dog. They also make the same general types of sounds and communicate in the same ways as dogs. Wolves vary in color, so even individual members of a pack can be easily distinguished. They range from pure black, shades of gray, to almost white.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.